Welcome back, Redeemers. Amen. What's going on? We still in the midst of comeback week.
What's up, Army? I'm Nick.
I'm Keith.
And I'm Curtis.
Hold up, everybody. Army, take a look at Keith Young.
Oh, my God. Oh, the BTS title.
He came here real Borahe-ish for y'all. So if you love Army, if you love Pantan Sonyadon and you love us, show Keith Young some love for coming here with very dapper and debonair with his Borahe tie on. You know what I'm saying? Hashtag Borahe Keith.
Or that's the thing.
Something like that. Something. Get creative with it. But without further ado, this is quotation mark from Jung Ho Suk, Kim Nam Joon, and Jian Jungkook.
Girl, I know you're mad at me, but we gotta get this thing back together. We won forever. Big Papa like that.
This one not unreleased.
I think it's unreleased or something like that.
Damn.
Yeah, I think it's unreleased.
I'm gonna find out where this is before this reaction is over. Y'all can start. I love this song.
I love how nostalgic it made me feel.
Yeah.
This remind me of like those like. I'm not comparing them to like Chingy or nothing, but like the holding me back kind of like those, you know, like where someone sings you into a rapper or somebody.
You just said that now, you just made me got a request. I was staring at you. Go ahead.
But it reminds me of like those, and if y'all love like R&B or just kind of the mid 2000s, like I guess urban pop. Yeah. Yeah. Urban pop probably is a nice pop way to put it. Yeah, pop and B. That's a nice way to put it, pop and B. Just those type of songs where like somebody would sing and then somebody would be rapping on it and stuff like that. It kind of was in that register of like music, and I love that a lot. I love the inflections that JK was able to do on his voice. He was hitting like different cadences like in line. he snapped on that on the hook. RM, you came in with a punch. First bar.
Yeah.
Shit, bro, we need you on Earth. We need you around, bro, for this good music. Yeah, this was good, man. This I like this a lot. Go ahead, y'all go off. I'll jump back into it.
That violin riff at the end?
Yeah, I think this might have just
been that's just something it's, that they play at the lyric.
It adds to the reflectiveness, though.
Oh, I was about to say, ain't got nothing to do with the song, though.
Maybe, first completely time hearing it, so I don't give a shit,
unrelated.
You never heard this? When we do the, they play beats at the end of it, so it's, you know, not a, what you call it, issue.
Nope.
So it's not a copyright.
Violin, one of my favorite instruments.
Well, to try to kind of kill the copyright.
Go, y'all can jump back into
something.
That's a good point.
Now, I thought this was cool. It didn't stand out to me as much as maybe some of the other people. That's fine. I did like Hope's verse and Cadence. He definitely came in and kind of killed it. It definitely gave me a throwback vibe. Kind of gave me like a Big Papa type melody vibe. For those that know, if you don't, Big Papa.
Oh yeah.
If not, you should do some research. But that's cool. Either way. Now, I thought this was good. I thought everybody came in and did what they needed to do. I thought RM was very good as far as kind of setting the table, setting the mood of explaining how different quotation marks or different punctuation marks can mean certain things to him, and when it comes to relationship and love and how he feels and what he wants to convey. And quotation mark, you know what I mean, makes you know that it came directly from me. It's a quote from me that I love you or whatever. Mm-hmm. In a relationship. Like, I got all that. No, it was cool. I don't know why. This just didn't really hit with me. But it's still a solid song, but I don't think I download it.
What's up, Kurt?
What's up? No, I like this a lot. I don't necessarily know if it's a download for me on the first listen or anything like that, but it's like, I'm definitely really curious about if this was a vaulted track that just got released again, or if this was, you know, something new that they came up with, you know, on the album or anything like that. And one of the reasons I'm bringing that up is because the nature of the lyrics are much more regretful and kind of darker, and I know they're in a much more beautiful place now, so I don't know if this is, you know, them, because I believe it, RM had said basically that they, you know, they would like go through whatever they're going through, talk about it openly amongst each other, and then only when they got past it much later would they release that kind of thing to Army. And we've seen that in, you know, some of the Rise of Bangtan episodes and things of that nature. So I don't know if this was one of those things, as far as like, you know, because we see the how they're in a much happier place now, if this is them kind of reflecting on a moment where they weren't as happy, perhaps. Nonetheless, though, I was just curious about that. But the song itself, I really loved everything as far as what was brought to the table, particularly with JK's vocals, which are, you know, he's my favorite vocalist in the group. But, you know, I love what he did with, vocally on this track. I would have perhaps liked a little bit more of a run at the end, perhaps, but that's just because I just love, you know, his voice so much. Everything that RM did in his verse and everything like that, I love the passion and sort of aggression. Like, I feel like when he gets into that sort of aggressive bag when he's rapping, like, particularly with his flow and his cadence and everything, the energy that he brings on it, like, I just, I think he really snaps when he's in that zone as well. Because we're, you know, often used to seeing him in a lot of more of a reflective, kind of more calm-mannered sort of nature. And it's when he's in, you know, moods like this, which is, again, why I thought perhaps it was an older track that was vaulted and then released subsequently. But I thought he snapped on this. I mean, opening, you know, even as Nick had said, the first bar, if I die, I'm not going to heaven, basically. Mm-hmm. That was kind of reflecting. And funny enough, he said something about we live, or we don't live truthfully, seven lives daily or something like that.
Yeah.
And it, I don't know if seven lies was a reference just because BTS is seven members. I didn't know if it was to say their persona of who they are on stage is each a false version of themselves. Granted, a translation doesn't necessarily have to mean a lie in particular. It could mean, you know, just a shadow of yourself, perhaps, as opposed
like Wu-Tang.
To like, exactly. But I didn't know if it was alluding to something like that, but I thought nonetheless in the lyricism of that was really interesting. But you also hear like, you know, like seven gates or seven deadly sins and stuff like that. I think there's like seven gates of hell and everything like that. So just the number seven in it is very poetic, so I don't necessarily know if he was alluding to any of those things. But I did really like his verse as well. And then when it got into Hope's verse, I was expecting it to be a little bit more, well, for lack of a better term, hopeful, just because I know that he kind of brings much more of a positivity. But his verse was also kind of on a more somber, sort of passionately aggressive as well. But it sounded amazing when he was in that bag. It just was a little sad just because I know he's, you know, J-Hope, so I always want to see all them happy and everything like that. But he had a really good line too, which I thought was a reference to Nirvana, as far as I'm cold, don't put my heart in a box, the heart-shaped box thing. Okay. I felt like that was sort of a reference to Nirvana, though I could be wrong. And I just know their musical array as far as what they listen to stretches so far beyond, you know, what we can even grasp. So I was just curious more so on that reference. But they all snapped in it, like, lyrically, as far as what they did, their flows, their cadences, Cookie's vocals were beautiful. So the track honestly did have everything for me. I just need a little bit more time to perhaps digest it and see its relation to the album, and particularly what piece of the puzzle, what part of the story is it's being told within the concept of the album and everything. But as its own track, it's really solid. I'm just very curious about the backstory and everything of it.
Yo, this really sound like one of those tracks, man. If y'all know, y'all know, man. If this was a music video, right now J-Hope would be with his boys. She'd be over there with her boyfriend or something. He'd be looking at her. They bump into each other later on. Like,
it would be in like 2006 or maybe 2008. He got a sidekick. And you know what I'm saying? He got a sidekick in his hand.
Only thing that would have doubled down, if JK would have been harmonizing hard, like when the rap is going on, he'd have just been in bed like, like, you know what tracks I'm talking about. Y'all know too. Y'all know Army.
It's funny. Hyung and Kurt haven't heard this song yet, but we're going to react to it eventually, or pretty probably tomorrow or whenever next time we come in. It reminds me of We Belong Together from Big Bang. It's in that same vein of
what year did Big Bang drop? That's
06. It's actually their debut song, but I don't want to spill too many beans on it because we didn't react to it.
Look, could you run this
one? Yeah, it's coming. It's
looping. No, I just mean I know the outros.
Oh, yeah. This song, I'm not even one of them bulls, but this song right here, I love this song off the rip, like hearing it. Just the production, because I'll say this, whereas others,
yes, yeah, yeah. Hey, Army, I'm not even gonna say the song. If you know, you know. Stop.
Yes.
But yes. Let's see who. Let's see if y'all know that. If y'all just drop the name of that song in the comments, just want to see where y'all was at during that time. But I love love songs. I'm always going to be a sucker for romance and kind of just boo-loving songs and everything like that. That's just kind of the songs I look for. So when BTS do these kind of songs, I appreciate it a lot, particularly Just One Day. And, even though I Need You is not romantic, it's somewhat there, you know what I'm saying, and everything like that. But I mean, Love Maze too. You know, Serendipity, which is... Serendipity might be top 12 for me right now. I'm going to be honest.
It's rising in the charts.
Yeah, that shit grew. But it might be over. Come on. I ain't going
to. Might be over what?
Let's focus on negativity.
A little crazy. But no, literally, this is my rap bias and my rap and vocal records. I have no one who stood out. Everyone killed it equally to me. I love RM's more like, I ain't gonna say idiosyncratic type raps and everything like that, but I love his approach to it. And then you get J-Hope with the more like mellowed traditional rap style and everything. He comes in there, like you said, just kind of get at, definitely not Chingy.
Yeah, that's what I said. It wasn't saying Chingy.
Mid-2000s kind of like
the boy that just like, you was with your girls and I was with my boys and we was chilling, and you know what rap I'm.
He's sitting on the side of the hood of the car.
It kind of gives that like innocent vibe.
He said he's sitting on the side of the hood of his car.
Waiting outside
for it to come out.
Or he just sitting there observing while they across the street.
And JK just under the just on the gate with a varsity jacket on, just
eat okay.
Or you know what, they flip the camera around. He actually.
Y'all all just naming the One Call Away video.
Mm-hmm. That's his character. That really is what it is.
That's all it is. Because what's his face was stinging in the jaw? Tingy was on the side of the
if
car.
If you were my baby.
You were my baby.
No, we might got to react to it until tonight, bro. Because now.
Wait. Are we calling Cookie Jason Weaver? Is that what we doing?
Hey, Jason Weaver saying, I want to be the Lion King.
Jason Weaver saying, the Lion King. Shannon, he was the Lion King. Jason.
But, like I said, everyone killed this. JK's vocals, man, like we said, is super smooth. The only problem I have with this is that it's not available on streaming. That really sucks. I actually agree with you, Kurt, though. I wish JK took us home on this one. Like, at the end, kind of, like, belted a little bit more and everything like that. But it's okay. Once I go over there and start producing and compose the song and arranging, we'll make that happen. You know what I'm saying? So,
yeah, and not that it's a flaw or anything like that, but yeah. I did want Shug as well.
I was going to say, yeah. I'm surprised he's not on here.
It feels like it's right in his lane.
I'm like, I know, like, you know, but then you get one more, and then one more person's going to come, and then one more.
And then for well, like, it's, be OT7
I think that's probably their thinking when they do something.
Yeah, I guess
like,
that's my thing is, like, not that it's a bad thing or anything like that. It's just more so my, like, I wonder behind the scenes kind of what, like, led someone to not be a part of it or to, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just things like that.
Right, RM. RM and J-Hope wrote the song with P-Dawg, and P-Dawg produced the song.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I was just about to ask you. Produce.
Yeah, so, you know. I would assume RM probably just be like, it probably really turns into that situation where he'd be like, yo, let Vegan on here. If I let Vegan on here, then I got to let Sugar get on here. If I let Sugar on here, then everyone might as well be, you know what I mean? Because I don't think we've seen a unit where it's five of them. It's most of the times either three, four, or the whole group.
Yeah. Usually. Yeah. And this, because this one,
it wasn't me saying I need Sugar on this or anything like that. It was more so I felt
thinking that too because I was like, I can imagine Sugar coming over here and kind of just going off. Like, this is really like his vibe.
Dimple, everybody?
I think it was everybody.
You said what?
Dimple was everybody, right?
I'll have to go back and look. I haven't listened to it in a while.
Well, it's been a while, so I'm not gonna front act like that's on my playlist.
Yeah,
no.
But this is, like I said, this is a really dope song. It's very nostalgic. I'm gonna have to find a way for this to get played, even though I don't got YouTube Premium. It's gonna have to be on either SoundCloud, or I'm gonna have to download it and manually put it on through iTunes. And what fun will that be? So, but no, I love this song. Like I said, I love the nostalgic vibes. J-Hope killed this part. RM killed this. Runch killed this part. JK killed this part.
JK was sneakily doing it.
No, I love when JK do the harmonizing with the rap line.
Oh, with the.
I didn't even hear that.
He's sneaking his way on there. And I know sometimes maybe y'all get tired of us saying that. That shit just puts the cherry on top of everything for me personally. Mm. When people do those harmonize, those run, it also fills out the track. Sometimes, like those little, like those kick-ins or punch-ins with the bars, just bro, turn the track.
I told you, I love it. When I listen to Blood, Sweat, and Tears, I spun back because oh my god,
those fill the track.
I heard it. No, I didn't catch that until like I was at work and like listening to it through headphones.
I told you that. Y'all love the car test. I'm telling you, that headphone test is something nasty.
Well, the car test will work for me too. I would catch it.
I do both.
This joint, them speaker test, it wasn't passing. But it's a lot of songs I ran. Remember, like I said, Serendipity too.
We weren't even on these speakers yet at the time. Remember,
what I said. The little speakers. That's what I'm saying. Them jokes.
They got us some good times.
He said, "Fuck y'all time."
He said, "Not saying we don't appreciate what your speakers did.
Them damn Dell speakers didn't do it."
Are they definitely not Dells?
I definitely appreciate when they do add some of those vocal things, as far as like, you know, especially if it's any kind of love story or even like an in your head sort of thing. You kind of use the echo as like a narrative, kind of like bouncing thoughts off yourself, whether like whatever you're questioning and everything. And I do think that would have fit with the whole quotation mark as far as like solidifying what you think or what you feel. And it's not that they didn't do it, like as you said, you know, it's in the track, it's sneakily, but it's just like that just would have been the cherry on top specifically.
It's like it was a sprinkle when it should have been a pour. But you know,
I want extra. I want extra
like that.
Was this track finished? Like, is this the finished track?
I would have to do more.
I would believe so, but love. I can't say for sure.
Some other people would have been on here, and this whole part would have been like, it would have turned into something like that, and then
y'all just harmonizing.
It would have turned into something like that, and that would have put a little bit more, just like, okay. And I will say too, y'all, because I don't want y'all to, like, sometimes we'll say something and we might get it, y'all don't. Mm-hmm. All them runs at the end aren't equal the same. Yeah. Like, I feel like it's certain ways to do those particular runs. I don't want people just to think like, y'all, it's like y'all want to fucking run at the end of every
No, one thing I will say, at the end of every single run that we talked about, none of their runs had sound the exact same.
Yeah.
Whether that be how it's layered with the beat or how it's integrated volume-wise, or whether, you know, whether it's a harmony versus, you know.
Exactly.
Like they integrate it so uniquely, and it may seem like it's just ad-lib, but it really, like, does add emotion to everything in the track, but nonetheless. So.
No, yeah, I, okay. That's it. You got to take you to church kind of level of which the producer. Soulful one. You got to show off your vocals, one, which is more aligned what we JK expect to kind of hear.
Oh, baby.
Veer somebody to be like,
but like, so I was
now
just
you're making me think.
No, but like I was just telling Nick, it's not so much the run too, but it's also how the producer incorporates the run.
The run.
So you don't have to put the run at full level to where it's like blaring over the track. You can just have it low.
You can fade out
and have it fade out.
I think the fade out's arguably most.
I still would have had the track run a little longer too.
Arguably most effective is the fade out.
Yeah, fading out, it is like, ooh. Because I love that. I'm not sure what that is.
Especially with love. You feel like the love's getting further away. You're just like, who's
if you know, whistle joint, yeah.
So some of the best runs are fade outs. Like,
last thing
you don't got a call. Yeah.
I'm not waiting. We were listening to Someday the other day. That joint,
Fade outs. See, yeah.
Bye.
Last thing I was gonna add was just particularly in J-Hope's verse. I really loved how he kind of played on the whole, like, I'm gonna basically be the devil. I'll be in front of you. I'll be behind you. Like, I'm gonna be that temptation for you and everything like that. But then, you know, he kind of said, like, regardless of all the feelings and everything, it's something I'm still gonna want anyway. And he was like, basically, that's gonna be, yeah, the genie line, as far as like, that's gonna be the thing I'm wishing for.
Trying to help
but,
you out.
But as you know, it kind of, it's funny because one of the things they talk about with a genie in general is you can't wish for what? Wealth, love, yeah. And I think like life or
bringing
something.
Bringing people
like that.
Back to life.
Yeah, bringing people back to life. So it's just funny that one of the forbidden kind of rules is like the thing you want. And I just thought that played beautifully into
not
into
being able to wish for wealth is some bullshit, but we can leave on that note.
No. You can wish for wealth.
He said, one sincere moment, a question mark of courage. I want that now. Mm. He started talking that.
And that's the thing. When it goes from being a quotation mark to a question mark to a comma to an exclamation point. So all the punctuation. Grammatical wordplay that was in there for sure as well.
But Army, we love y'all. We had so much fun. It's a good one. Like I said, I'm going to find my way to get this, John.
Or not.
Like I said. Oh, speaking of which, thanks for reminding me, Sassy Man. Leave Keith Young some comments in there.
Man.
Hashtag Bora Hey Keith.
Hashtag
Our Purple Keith. Yeah.
Or not. You don't have to.
Yes, you do. So Keith Young some love. Nah. But we're up out of here. We see y'all next vid.
Love y'all. Take care.